Now let's do the exercise at page 156. Multiple choice questions. Comprehension. Number 1. What would have most upset a woman the day everything went wrong for her? 那么在一切变得出差错的那一天，什么事情令戴维女士最感到不安呢？ Now listen to me carefully, and I think what I'm talking about can remind you. As if this were not enough to reduce you to tears, your husband arrives, unexpectedly brings three guests to dinner. That's what you cannot expect, right? So, according to this sentence we know, the answer should be C. Her husband had not told her he was bringing anyone to dinner. Got it? Okay, number 2. What might have prevented a chain reaction following the initial collision? Initial, 首次的。那么什么事情有可能防止连锁的反应呢？ We choose boy. Had there been a more experienced driver behind the two cars? 这是省略 if 的虚拟条件句。If there had been a more experienced driver behind the two cars. In fact, we know. Immediately behind the two cars happened to be a learner.我们知道紧跟在两车之后的这位女士恰巧是一个初学开车的人。She got into panic. And then, catastrophe occurred one after another. 那么大家知道这个灾难是一个接着一个而发生。So we choose boy. 假如其后一个开车的人是很富有经验的 I should say,She would prevent a chain reaction. Don't you think so? Now number 3. There was a second angry argument. Because, 那么为什么又发生了第二次愤怒的争吵呢? We choose A. The lorry driver blamed the owner of the cake for his accident. When the lorry driver saw a cake flying through the air,He stopped his car all of a sudden. So in our opinion, he must have blamed the owner of the cake. Right? So, according to the story the writer described, we choose A. Now, key structures. Number 4. It is as if a single event, that is, a chain of reactions. 不重要的事情会导致连锁的反应。That is, 一定要注意，这是定语从句修饰 ,event, got it? 不重要的事件，我们可以采用 unimportant, 但这个形容词要放在 event 之前。It is as if a single unimportant event. 那么如果采用定语从句在正式的书面英语当中，我们可以表达为 that is of no importance.That is of no importance. Let us say, that is unimportant. As I mean, that is of no importance. 修饰 event. 而 set up 是整个句子的伪动词。Number 5. You are preparing a meal, keeping an eye on the baby. 这是典型的现在分词做状语。当你在照料婴儿的时候，你同时在准备晚饭。While keeping an eye on the baby, 前几课我们曾经论述过，为使得现在分词做时间状语更加明确，可以在分词 ing 之前加出 while. So we choose dog. Number 6. As if this you to tears, 仿佛这一切还不足以使你流下眼泪。So as if this has not already reduced you to tears, that something much worse will happen. 你要知道更糟糕的事情还会紧接着发生。我们采用现在完成时表达其结果。Number 7. Immediately behind the two cars. happen to be a learner. 为强调两车之后 behind the two cars 这个介词短语，我们把它调制到句首。如果介词短语调制到句首，句子必须采用倒装形式，全部倒装。So, be 动词 was 要放在主语 a woman 之前。Behind the two cars was a woman. Got it. So we choose A. Number 8. The police spent nearly an hour spend time doing something. So getting the traffic on the move again. 不能选择 dog 选项，只是强调花时间做某事，所以不能使用完成时态。Number 9.Vocabulary. You are preparing a meal and the baby at the same time. And 前后连接的两个形式相呼应，所以采用 ing 现在分词，现在进行时态。You are preparing a meal and watching the baby. Number 10. She stopped her car. In our original text, we use.Got into panic, 陷入慌乱之当中。那么强调在混乱当中，在恐惧当中，还是表示在恐慌当中，我们要用介词 in panic, in terror, in fear, in horror. Number 11. Hundreds of them, the back of the vehicle. 原文使用 slid off.这里不能选择 C 选项。Slid over 表示躲过。For example, he slid over the question without answering it. 他避开了这个问题没有回答。He slid over the question without answering it. 那么根据我们所掌握的知识，应该选择 A. Slip off 表示滑落。Number 12. They greatly devoured the of the cake.剩余的蛋糕 So what was left of the cake? 那么应该选择 dog Remains Remains 表示所剩余的部分除此而外也表示遗址遗体而 C 选项 left over 通常采用复数形式 left overs 指剩下的东西一定要注意通常使用的是复数形式 For example残羹剩饭都喂给了狗 The leftovers of the meal were fed to the dog. Now listen to me once more. The leftovers of the meal were fed to the dog. Are you quite clear about the exercise? So much for lesson 33. Anyway, please try your best to learn it by heart as quickly as possible. Lesson 34.A happy discovery, 幸运的发现。Now please open your books at page 158. Read after me the following words aloud. Please pay more attention to the pronunciation. Antique, antique. Fascination, fascination. Forbidding, forbidding. Master, master. Pretentious, pretentious.Labyrinth, labyrinth. Rarity, rarity. Assorted, assorted. Junk, junk. Litter, litter. Dedicated, dedicated. Bargain hunter, bargain hunter. Dealer, dealer. Cherish. Amply, amply. Masterpiece, mere.Mirror, prize, prize, cub, cub, dagger, dagger, miniature, miniature, composition, composition. Now let's learn how to use the first word, fascination. Fascination is a noun. It means the power of fascinating, charm, the power of fascinating, charm.迷惑力魅力常用介词 for, over, on 搭配引用 For example Cats have an unfailing fascination for most people Cats have an unfailing fascination for most people Understand me? Now translate the sentence. You will be the case structure. 中国艺术对我有一种极强的魅力。Chinese art has a great fascination for me. 一定要注意，这是一个固定的句式结构。Have fascination for somebody. For somebody. 像我们刚刚所提到的，猫总是对人有一种永不衰败的迷惑力。Cats have an unfailing fascination for most people. 而中国艺术对我有一种极强的魅力。Chinese art has a great fascination for me. OK? Fascination. Of course, we learn how to use fascinate in lesson 9. 我们在第九课已经学到了如何运用 fascinate 这个动词形式。Those of you remember how to use it? Fascinate, attract or interest very strongly. Attract or interest very strongly 表示使着迷。那么这个形式多用于被动式。Now please listen to me carefully. Cats never fail to fascinate human beings. Cats never fail to fascinate human beings. Got it? 那么在这个表达方式当中Fascinate, 及物动词。So, 猫总是能够引起人们的极大兴趣。那么如果你想表达英语总是能够引起学生的极大兴趣。English never fails to fascinate students. Got it? 我们在使用被动语态的时候常用语结构 be fascinated by something or be fascinated with something. For example,He's fascinated with chess. 他迷上了象棋。The students were fascinated by his idea. 学生们对他的想法非常的感兴趣。Are you quite clear about fascinate? 在掌握 fascinate, fascination 的同时，同学们要把握住 charm, 迷住，使陶醉，令人喜爱。但是他的语气比 fascinate 要弱。For example, the beautiful picture charms me. Or, I'm charmed by the beautiful picture. Got it? Captivate. C-A-P-T-I-V-A-T-E. Captivate. 表示迷惑，使着迷。它可以相当于 fascinate 的用法，使着迷。但是有一个 fascinate 所没有的语义，迷惑。他的这个主意迷惑了我。His idea captivated me. Okay, next, enchant. E-N-C-H-A-N-T. 这是我们以后要学到的一个词汇。也表示使迷惑。但它更重点的用法主要强调用魔法迷惑。使心醉，使喜悦。我们也用语结构 be enchanted by 或 be enchanted with. For example,She was enchanted by the flower you sent her. She was enchanted by the flower you sent her. 看到你送给她的鲜花，她心醉了。在我们刚刚所提到的 fascinate, charm, captivate, enchant 这些动词后，直接加 ing， 如以 e 结尾去掉 e 加 ing， 就变成了相应的形容词形式 charming。Fascinating, enchanting, captivating. Okay, now read after me. Charming, fascinating, enchanting, captivating. 能表示有吸引力的。